With the hindsight, benefit of hindsight, people felt that once you privatize their power, that we will have power abundance of power supply. But that's not it. You know, so we only sell a monkey, we sold a monkey, and you know, and they need to have a dog. You know, and nothing changed, you know, with their lengthy tails. So nothing for our people. So we want a change. Nigeria desired a change. So these things are not coming. What you're having is that the electricity companies now are moving around, tell you drop your meter and pick a new one. Drop this and that. Nothing is moving. Even to sell meter. So that you will not go into estimated billing. We don't even have it. So for me, it is a short change. It's a scam of the highest order. If we don't go and address that issue, if this government, because the licenses they gave had expired last year, we expect Buhari to have the courage to either revoke that thing or compel the electricity companies to do the needful. If they don't, let them not give them renew the licenses. This is not the way things should be done. Nigerians deserve better. Let us help our people here. We are talking about unemployment here. How can you have a great job when the private sector are not there? When the private sector are not driving the economy? Nothing. Government cannot employ the whole army of unemployed that are living in university every year, coming out from youth service. There is none. Not until we do that. That's only when things can work. How many industries can survive using generator sets? Buying gas. Do you know what it takes to buy gas? To even manage a home, run a home, buy gas in an average family. It takes almost 15,000 naira weekly, you know, to buy 15 liters of gas. 15,000 naira for families that are very small. Talk less of an industry. So how can an industry survive in Nigeria and use gas to power its factory? It's not possible. That's why people are living in their droves. Almost all the companies here go to Enugu and Namco has gone. You know, you go to the go to Lagos. How many companies are still standing there? What we are now doing is buying and selling. And that's no way you can reflect the economy. You can never add to the GDP of this country with buying and selling. You know, and that's why things are not working. We only depend on the crude oil sales, which is no longer going. It's no longer working. Even now, most of the developed countries are now changing to electric cars. So they are pushing down the ones they have rejected down here. Very soon, you will not be seeing people who are buying. So this is the issue. We really have to, as a country, sit up and get things done. Let's get the people that have applied to run this power sector be held accountable. That's the only way we can do it. And we feel that President Buhari must discharge his responsibility as is concerned, because this is part of his election promise he made in 2015 and 2019. So if by 2023 we are still on this issue, it means it's a failure on his side and all of us here. Well, you see, the misguided, you see, I want to say that during that round table we had, you know, it came to a session when there was almost a breakdown in communication over there, because there are people who have ideas, who are involved in the industry, who have the ideas how to get this done fast and then solve rural. And then you discover that people who are in charge, you know, the Nigerian Electricity Regulatory Commission, you know, that there are a few things we expected them to do. They are not doing, you know, so we are not happy about that. You know, we must have round pegs and round holes. We have to, if they don't get it at that policy level, so how who will follow the orders? You know, so who will go and ensure that things are done? So we met in that our power reform, in that round table we had on power. We discovered that many people were not happy with the way things are going. Some people were quarreling amongst themselves, and we called them to order. And we told them that nobody should be booked down here for punishment or wanting a punishment or the other. Because we want people to expose the trouble we have in the system with a view to solving this problem. So we did all those that workshop we had to make sure that things work for our people. You know, so what we are advising the president that, you know, trying to get these things done, he has to retool. He has to look at the people who are in places. It's not just enough to give political positions based on patronage. You know, it's not. We should look for competent people who have ideas and put them in places. Because this problem of electricity is not a rocket science. You know, I myself, while doing that my motion, did a lot of consultations. I even have to Google and find how other countries are doing things. In Abuja, you have only Abuja Electricity Distribution Company. In UK, let me just take the southern part of UK, South End on Sea. You have over five electricity companies in South End on Sea, a very small small community. So if this one is not working, the other one, you move to the other. But in the whole Abuja metropolis, you have this. You go to Enugu, you have the whole in southeastern states. Enugu Electricity Development Company is not possible. This is monopoly. You know, we are shortchanging ourselves. That's why I would say we've sold the monkey and bought the dog. You know, so, and you still find the thing that crouches and while sitting. So we have to change. Nothing has changed. It's only changing names, you know. So we really want not just changing in what, but change indeed, so that things can work for people. We are still having suffering monopoly in Abuja. We expect not less than up to 10 electricity distribution companies here competing for space. In Lagos, we expect the same thing. Southwest, with the same thing in the South South. We should not farm this thing out to individuals. You know, because it does appear, you know, that there is a front that have taken over these jobs. And this Senate, this National Assembly, this Ninth Assembly is working very hard to ensure that we address this issue. Because we are no longer waiting for the executive to come up with policies. We are taking the fight to them. That's what we have resolved in this Ninth Assembly. And that's why we have made up our minds here that we must work with the executive. We must work with the president. What we had in the 8th Assembly, that one has gone down the history lane, you know. So, but in this present 9th Assembly, we decided to bridge the gap so that Nigerians will not complain that things are not moving. That's the part of the reason why some people are there criticizing that the National Assembly is in the pockets of anybody. We are not in pockets of anybody. We are here for convenience sake to solve the problems so that things work, so that we can have ease of doing our business here. That's just it. So that's what we are doing. So if we have to be in the pocket of Mr. President to get the power for the country, my brother, I will even sleep there in that pocket. You know, if by doing so we'll have employment created for our people, my brother, I will sleep in the pocket of Mr. President. Anywhere at all. But let us solve problem here. Enough of complaints. Nigerians are tired of that. Nigerians want good things of them. Nigerians is not too demanding too much from the government. They are not too demanding.